Dear students, in our next lecture, we will now study about the vibrational rotational spectroscopy. In our previous lectures, we have studied about the rotational spectroscopy. And we have also studied about the vibrational spectroscopy. In this vibrational spectroscopy, we have studied about the vibrational rotor. We have studied about the simple harmonic oscillator. And then we have also studied about the degrees of freedom. That is, how many modes of vibrations are present for a given molecule. If it is a polyatomic molecule, then we can have it 3n-5 or 3n-6 number of vibrational modes of degrees of freedom we can have it. So that vibrational motions can be of these many numbers, where n is the total number of atoms associated with the molecule. If the molecule is linear, then we will have 3n-5 modes of vibrations. And if it is non-linear, then it will be 3n-6 will be there. This 5 and 6 because we have a total of 3 translational motions and 2 or 3 rotational motions associated. 2 when the molecule is linear, we have molecular axis is not changing any of the positions of any atoms, so we are not considering that rotational motion. But otherwise, 2 rotational motions for linear molecule and 3 rotational motions for non-linear molecule. And so it will be 3 plus 2, 5 for a linear molecule. So 3n-5 will be the number of modes of vibrational motions, and 3 plus 3, 6, that is 3n-6 number of modes of vibrations for non-linear molecules. Now, whenever we are going for this linear vibrational motion, we have seen that it is giving us the energy delta E will be equal to V plus half into H nu zero, that is E is equal to V plus half into H nu zero, where if we are going a transition from one vibrational state to another vibrational state, we have delta E will be equal to, or the frequency that is associated with this will be equal to nu equals to V2 minus V1 into nu zero. So in this case, V2 is the higher energy state, higher vibrational state. V1 is the lower vibrational state. So when it is going from lower to higher vibrational states, whatever the energy is required, its frequency will be given by V2 minus V1 into nu zero. This nu zero is the fundamental vibrational frequency. Now, in this case, what happens is, whenever we are having a selection rule of V2 minus V1 is equal to 1, we will find that it is giving us only one single vibration motion. So in a vibrational motion, pure vibrational motion, we will have only one single peak corresponding to this nu and nothing else, because if they are equidistant, lines, vibrational lines are equidistant lines. So each one of them will be giving rise to same frequency vibrational motion. So it will be giving us only one single peak rather than a spectrum. So this is of very little use, but whenever we are doing a vibrational motion, the vibrational motion's energy is about 1000 times higher than the rotational motions. So what happens is, in between two vibrational energy levels, that is, if we are having a V1 and a V2, there will be lots of rotational energy levels will be present over here. We know that rotational energy levels are not equidistant, so their distance increases as we go higher and higher. So this will be there, then that is J is equal to 0, say J1 is equal to 0, J1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Here let it be J2 is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So whenever we are having a transition from V is equal to V1 to V2 vibrational energy levels, it will also accompany a transition between the rotational energy levels. So it will be having, we will not be having a pure vibrational spectrum, but we will have a vibrational spectrum associated with a rotational spectrum. So we will have a vibrational rotational spectrum will be associated with it, and not just the vibrational motion. So this we call it as a vibrating rotor. The molecule which is undergoing such a motion, that is, it is having a vibrational motion associated with a rotational motion, we call it as a vibrating rotor, because it is rotating and also it is vibrating. So we call it as a vibrating rotor. In today's class, we will study about the spectrum associated with this vibrating rotors. Now, this vibrating rotor, as it is undergoing vibrational motion as well as the rotational motion, so its total energy will be having both the vibration energies as well as the rotational energies. So our E total for this will be equal to E vibration plus it will be having E rotational energies. So it will have a E vibration plus E rotations. We know that E vibration is given by V plus half into H nu zero, where nu zero is the fundamental vibrational frequency, V is the vibrational quantum number. E rotation, we have studied it, that it is given by J into J plus one into H square upon 8 pi square pi, where J is the rotational quantum number, I is moment of inertia. So now the total energy E total will be equal to E vibration plus E rotation. So it will be equal to V plus half H nu zero plus J into J plus one into H square upon 8 pi square I. So this will be the total energy associated with a vibrating rotor. Now, whenever the vibrating rotor is undergoing transitions, when the molecule undergoes transition, when molecule undergoes transition from, say, V1 to V2, accompanied by J1 to J2. J1 is the rotational energy level in vibrational energy level V1, and J2 is the rotational energy level in vibrational energy level V2. We know that whenever it is a vibrational energy levels, say V1, and say this is our vibrational energy level V2, both of these are accompanied by many rotational energy levels. These are rotational energy levels, where this is J1s, all these are J1, and here we have all the J2s. J2s are non-equidistant, while V's are all equidistant. The energy difference between V1 and V2 will be same between V2 and V3. V3 and V4, it will be same, but J1, J2 ka jo difference hoga, yahan pe ye do energy levels ka difference will be different than these two energy levels. So it will be different for rotational energy level, lekin vibrational energy level mein ye jo gap hai, ye gap hamesha same rehta hai. So this is J1s and these are all J2s. So J2 are the rotational energy levels in vibrational energy level V2, and J1 are the rotational energy levels in vibrational energy level V1. So jab bhi molecule V1 se V2 mein jayega, to uske saath saath rotational energy levels mein bhi changes aayenge. So that will be giving us the rotational vibrational spectrum. We are trying to find out this particular difference in energies for the rotational vibrational energy levels. Now for that, what we will have is delta E will be equal to E2 minus E1, energy of E2 minus the energy of E1. So this will be giving us E2 will be equal to V2 plus half H nu zero plus J2 into J2 plus 1. We are having this, where V say hamara V2 ho jayega, aur J जे टू हो जाएंगे, बाकी सारा सेम रहेगा. सो इट विल बी एच स्क्वायर अपॉन 8 पाई स्क्वायर आई. ये हमारा हुआ E2 माइनस E1. नाउ इट विल बी V1 प्लस हाफ इंटू एच न्यू जीरो प्लस J1 इंटू J1 प्लस 1 एच स्क्वायर अपॉन 8 पाई स्क्वायर आई. सो दिस विल बी अवर E1. सो E1 E2 माइनस E1 हमारा हुआ. So this E1, E2 minus E1 may, we can take this vibrational terms separate and the rotational terms separate. So if we simplify this, we will get V2 plus half H nu 0 minus V1 plus half H nu 0. So this will be our vibrational energies. हमारे दोनों हो गए. ये हमारा minus था, इसलिए ये पूरे term को हमने minus किया है. Now this will be plus, we will have it as J2 into J2 into J2 plus 1 H square upon 8 pi square I minus J1 into J1 plus 1 h square upon 8 pi square I. This we can simplify it. H nu 0 common हम ले सकते हैं बाहर में, और बाकी हमारा हो जाएगा V2 plus half, ये minus V1 minus half into H nu 0 plus, यहाँ पे हमारा h square upon 8 pi square I हम common ले सकते हैं बाहर. So this will be J2 into J2 plus 1 minus J1 into J1 plus 1 into H square upon 8 pi square I. Now here it will be this half and this half gets cancelled. So we will have it as V2 minus V1 into H nu 0 plus, यहां पर हम इसको सिंप्लीफाई करेंगे. सो वी विल हैव इट, दिस इज एज जे टू स्क्वायर प्लस जे टू माइनस जे वन स्क्वायर माइनस जे वन इंटू एच स्क्वायर अपॉन एट पाई स्क्वायर आई. सो दिस इफ वी फर्दर सिंप्लीफाइड, वी विल गेट दिस विल बी इक्वल टू वी टू माइनस वी वन H mu 0 plus, now here what we can do is, this is J2 square minus J1 square. So it is J2 square minus J1 square plus J2 minus J1 into H square upon 8 pi square pi. Now what we have is a square minus b square can be written as a plus b into a minus b. ये हमारा मैथ्स में हमने रिलेशनशिप ये पढ़ा था. a square minus b square can be written as a plus b into a minus b. So this j2 and j1 can be written as j2 minus j2 plus j1 into j1 j2 minus j1. So this will be equal to V2 minus V1 H nu 0 plus J2 plus J1 into J2 minus J1 plus J2 minus J1. ये हमारा J2 minus J1 वो वैसे ही रहेगा यहाँ पे. We will have H square upon 8 pi square R. Now here we can take out J2 minus J1 as common. So we will have it as V2 minus V1 into H nu 0 plus, यहाँ पे हमारा J2 minus J1 हमारा common आएगा. So J2 minus J1 common हो गया, और उसके बाद में हमारा जो बचेगा वो यहाँ से J2 plus J1 और यहाँ पे plus 1 बचेगा into H square upon 8 pi square R. So this becomes our delta E. Let this be our equation number A. This is our general expression. For vibrational rotational spectrum. Vibrational rotational spectrum के लिए ये हमारा general expression हो गया. इसमें हम J1, J2 and V1, V2 के values डालेंगे. So we will get all the different spectra. We can get the lines for the different spectrum. But for that we can have the selection rules. So selection rules for this rotational vibrational spectrum are same as that of the rotational spectrum and vibrational spectrum. So they are combination of vibrational and rotational spectrum. रोटेशनल और वाइब्रेशनल स्पेक्ट्रम में जो सिलेक्शन रूल्स थे उन्हीं का यहाँ पे कॉम्बिनेशन होता है. दैट इज डेल्टा वी इज इक्वल टू प्लस और माइनस वन एंड डेल्टा जे इज इक्वल टू प्लस और माइनस वन. सो दीज आर द टू सिलेक्शन रूल्स दैट वी हैव स्टडीड इन आवर वाइब्रेशनल स्पेक्ट्रम एंड रोटेशनल स्पेक्ट्रम. सेम यहाँ पर एप्लीकेबल होंगे लेकिन दोनों साथ में एप्लीकेबल होंगे. दैट इज डेल्टा वी हमारा प्लस माइनस वन इमीडिएटली नेक्स्ट वाइब्रेशनल लेवल या इमीडिएटली नीचे का वाइब्रेशनल लेवल में जा सकता है और रोटेशनल एनर्जी लेवल भी वही होगा इमीडिएट ऊपर वाला या फिर इमीडिएटली नीचे वाला. लेकिन यहाँ पे प्रॉब्लम कहाँ आती है कि एट रूम टेम्परेचर मॉलिक्यूल्स are in V is equal to zero vibrational level. At room temperature, molecules are in V is equal to zero vibrational levels. It means zero point energy पे रहते हैं molecules सारे at room temperature. Means कि zero energy level पे हो तो आप उससे नीचे minus one में नहीं जा सकते हो. You can only go up. Hence, we simplify selection rules. Hence, we have simplified selection rules as delta V is equal to plus one. Minus one वहाँ पे possible नहीं है क्योंकि हम already सबसे lowest energy level पे है. उसके नीचे हम जा नहीं सकते because उसमें कुछ भी नहीं है. So ऊपर ही हम जा सकते हैं vibrational level से. लेकिन at room temperature, rotational energy levels are occupied up to J is equal to 5. So up to J is equal to 5 में occupied है तो 5 से वो 4 में आ सकता है, 3 से 2 में जा सकता है, 1 से 0 में भी आ सकता है. So there are n number of possibilities for rotational spectrum to have a minus 1. Delta J is equal to minus 1 हो सकता है. लेकिन delta V is equal to minus 1 नहीं हो सकता है because our molecule is already in the lowest energy state. So we will have the selection rules will be delta V is equal to plus 1 and delta J is equal to plus or minus 1. So we have these selection rules now for this rotational vibrational spectrum. And accordingly, we can have two different things. That is, if we have say delta V and delta J. If we have a delta V plus 1 and delta J plus 1. If we have both plus 1, and we can have in another one where delta V is equal to plus 1 and delta J is equal to minus 1. Two situations we can have, either both plus 1s and in the second situation delta V plus 1, delta J minus 1. These two will give rise to different energy levels in the or different spectrums, different branches in the spectrum. Now this delta V plus 1 and delta J plus 1, this will be giving rise to R branch lines. While delta V plus 1 and delta J minus 1 will be giving rise to P branch lines. The lines that are coming through this particular selection rule are called as P branch lines, or delta J plus 1 mein jo lines aati hain, that we call it as R branch lines. So we will have R branch lines and we will have P branch lines. So in a rotational vibrational spectrum, we will have P and R branch lines will be present in that. Let us see what are the characteristics of this both P branch lines and R branch lines. So we will have see the wave numbers of say first R branch lines. Now for this, we have the equation as the general expression for this was equation A, that is delta E is equal to V2 minus V1 H nu 0 into J2 minus J1, J2 plus J1 plus 1 H square upon 8 pi square R. ये हमारा equation A है, यही equation से हम start करेंगे. फिर सिर्फ हमारा सिलेक्शन रूल होगा, वो सिलेक्शन रूल को हम फॉलो करेंगे यहाँ पे. सो वी विल हैव फॉर एक्सप्रेशंस फॉर आर ब्रांच लाइंस कैन बी देन गिवन एज डेल्टा ई इज इक्वल टू V2 minus V1 into H nu 0 plus J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1 H square upon 8 pi square R. So this was our expression say A. We can change this expression in terms of wave numbers as we are finding out the wave numbers over here. So यहाँ पे हम उसको wave numbers में convert कर सकते हैं. We have delta E is equal to H nu. So nu will be equal to delta E upon H. So that we can have it over here. So delta E upon H अगर हम करेंगे तो यहाँ से एक H cancel हो जाएगा और यहाँ से एक H cancel हो जाएगा because we are dividing by H throughout. So it will be dividing by H throughout. So nu equals delta E upon H will be equal to V2 minus V1 into nu 0. यहाँ का एक H निकल गया and we have J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1. यहाँ से भी एक H जाएगा, so we will have H upon 8 pi square R. Now we have this nu bar is equal to nu is equal to nu bar into C. So C nu bar is equal to nu. So what we can have is we can have this replace this by C nu bar. So we have to just multiply it by C. So we will have this as C nu bar will be equal to V2 minus V1, nu 0 का nu bar 0 करना है, तो C nu bar 0 plus J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1 into H upon 8 pi square R. यहाँ पे हमारा nu नहीं है, इसलिए वो वैसा ही रहेगा. Now if we divide it throughout by C, divide throughout by C, we get यहाँ पे C new bar का we will have new bar equals V2 minus V1 into again new bar new zero bar plus J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1 H upon 8 pi square I और यहाँ पे C आ जाएगा. Now what we have is since we have H upon 8 pi square I C, if you remember this is equal to Jerome's constant B0. So we can replace this by Jerome's constant B0. We will have nu bar is equal to V2 minus V1 into nu bar 0 plus J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1 into B0. This let be equation number B. This will be our starting point for R branch lines and P branch lines. So this is our important equation for this P branch and R branch lines. What we have is selection rules. For R branch lines, selection rules for R branch lines are delta V is equal to plus 1, hence V2 minus V1 is equal to plus 1, or we have V2 is equal to V1 plus 1. Similarly, we have delta J is equal to plus 1, so J2 minus J1 is equal to 1. Or we have J2 is equal to J1 plus 1. If we substitute this in the equation B, substituting this in equation B, we get nu bar is equal to V2 minus V1 is plus 1. So it will be plus 1 into nu bar 0 plus J2 minus J1 is 1. So it will be 1 into J2 is equal to J1 plus 1. So this will be J1 plus 1. Then again J1 plus 1 into B0. So what we will have is nu bar will be equal to nu bar 0 plus yahan pe it will be 2j1 plus 2. So 2 ko hum common kar sakte hain, 2 into j1 plus 1 b0. So this is the equation for R branch lines. This is equation for wave numbers of R branch lines. Wave numbers of R branch lines. So we can have this as for different R branch lines, different transitions, we can have it J1 is equal to 0 to J2 is equal to 1. Means transition from 0 to 1 rotational energy level, we will have nu bar is equal to nu bar 0 plus 2 into J1 is 0, so 0 plus 1 B0, that is equal to nu bar 0 plus 2 B0. For J1 is equal to 1, 2, J2 is equal to 2, we will have nu bar is equal to nu bar 0 plus 2 into, now J1 is 1, so 1 plus 1 B0, it will be equal to nu bar 0 plus 4 B0. Similarly, J1 is equal to 2 se agar transition ho raha hai, J2 is equal to 3 mein, then we will have nu bar is equal to nu bar 0 plus 6 B0. Similarly, we will have it for J1 is equal to 3 to J2 is equal to 4 mein. So nu bar 0 will be equal to nu bar 0 plus 8 B0. So what we can have is lines are jo hamara fundamental vibrational frequency hai plus 2 b0 plus 4 b0 6 b0 8 b0 means hamare jo lines hai wo equidistant honge. In dono lines ka jo difference hai that is equal to 2 b0. These two lines ka difference jo hai that is equal to 2 b0. So jo hamara rotational spectrum mein jo spacing tha wahi spacing humko yahan par bhi milega. So we can easily find out the rotational constant or the Jerome's constant from this. This was for R branch lines. We can have it for P branch lines also. For P branch lines, we have wave numbers for P branch lines. Wave numbers for P branch lines. This gives us the selection rules are for P branch lines. The selection rules are delta V is equal to plus 1 and delta J is equal to minus 1. So we will have V2 minus V1 is equal to 1 and J2 minus J1 is equal to minus 1. So what we can have is J1 is equal to J2 plus 1. अगर हमारा ये J1 उधर निकाले और plus minus 1 इस तरफ लेकर आएंगे तो we will get J1 is equal to J2 plus 1. अगर हम ये substitute करें equation B में अगर हम ये substitute करते हैं, we will have nu bar is equal to V2 minus V1 nu 0 bar plus J2 minus J1 into J2 plus J1 plus 1 B0. ये हमारा इक्वेशन था. This was our equation number B. So इसमें अगर हम ये सब्स्टिट्यूट करें, we will get nu bar 0 is equal to V2 minus V1 is 1 into nu 0 bar plus J2 minus J1 is minus 1 into J2 plus J1 is J2 plus 1 plus 1 equal to B0. So this will be equal to nu 0 bar plus, we will have it instead of plus, we will have minus 2J2 plus 2. So it will be 2 into J2 plus 1 B0. So this is our equation for P branch lines. Equation for P branch lines. So from this, what we can have is for different transitions, we can have delta J going from J1 is equal to 1 to J2 is equal to 0. So isme kya hoga? Nu bar will be equal to nu 0 bar minus 2 into J2 hamara 0 hai. So 0 plus 1 B0. So this will be equal to nu bar 0 minus 2b0. So here we are having minus 2b0. In R branch line, we were having plus 2b0. J1 is equal to 2 say J2 is equal to 1 mein aa raha hai. We have delta J is equal to minus 1. So upar ke level mein jab jayega to wo lower energy mein jayega. Rotational energy lower energy mein jayega. So this will be nu bar is equal to nu 0 bar minus 2 into J2 hamara abhi 1 hai, so 1 plus 1 B0 equals 2 into 2 4, so nu 0 bar minus 4 B0. Similarly for J2, J1 is equal to 3 to J2 is equal to 2, we will have nu bar is equal to nu bar 0 minus 6 B0 and so on we will have it. Yahan par bhi hamara jo difference aayega wo hamesha 2 B0 ka hoga. But jo inka spectrum hoga, that spectrum will be a different spectrum. Spectrum will be looking somewhat like this, where we have two vibrational energy levels, V is equal to 0 to V is equal to 1. So hamara V is equal to 0 se V is equal to 1 mein transition ho raha hai, aur ye transition hote samay rotational energy mein bhi transition ho raha hai. So this is our J1s. And these are all J2s. So J1 से J2 में जब अगर जा रहा है, अगर वो directly 0 to 0 में जाएगा, तो that will be giving us delta J is equal to 0. That we call it as Q branch lines and this we do not observe. That is why we have a dashed line over here. ये हमारा नहीं होता है. Spectrum में हमें यहाँ पे नहीं मिलता है Q branch lines. We get it only the R branch line and P branch lines. So R branch lines कब मिलती है? जब हमारा यहाँ पे J is equal to 0 से J is equal to 1 में जाता है. So 0 हमारा lower vibrational energy में and जो 1 है वो higher vibrational energy level में जो rotational energies है उनका यहाँ पर आएगा. So that we will be getting it over here. J is equal to 0 to 1 में. Similarly यहाँ पे we will have this as R0 line, this as R1 line जो है, J is equal to 1 to J is equal to 2. R2 line will be from J is equal to 2 to J is equal to 3 and so on. Hamara yahan pe lines rahenge. Similarly, P branch lines hume kab milenge? जब हमारा लोअर वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी में हायर रोटेशनल एनर्जी लेवल होगा, जैसे यहाँ पे जे इज इक्वल टू वन है, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेवल जे इज इक्वल टू वन है, और यहाँ पे हायर वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी में वो जे इज इक्वल टू जीरो में जा रहा है. सो वन से जीरो में जा रहा है. वेन इट इज चेंजिंग द वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी लेवल, रोटेशनल एनर्जी लेवल इज चेंजिंग फ्रॉम वन टू जीरो. उसी एनर्जी लेवल में, उसी वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी लेवल में यहाँ से या नीचे नहीं आ रहा है, देन इट विल बी गिविंग अस प्योर रोटेशनल लेवल. लेकिन यहाँ से दूसरे वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी लेवल में जब जा रहा है तो रोटेशनल एनर्जी लेवल चेंज हो रहा है. सो दैट इज फ्रॉम वन टू जीरो. सो इट इज माइनस वन चेंजेस देयर. सो वी विल हैव अ पी ब्रांच लाइन, हियर इट विल बी पी जीरो. टू से वन में जाएगा तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज पी वन लाइन. टू थ्री से टू में जाएगा तो पी टू लाइन, एंड सो ऑन वी विल हैव इट. सो वी विल हैव अकंपनीड बाय दिस द पी ब्रांच लाइन्स, पी जीरो, P1, P2, P3 and so on. और इस तरफ में हमारा होगा राइट हैंड साइड में R0, R1, R2 and so on. यहाँ पे इंटेंसिटी इन बिटवीन हमारा थर्ड फोर्थ लाइन में बढ़ता है, और दोनों P ब्रांच लाइन्स एंड R ब्रांच लाइन्स में. दिस इज बिकॉज की रिलेटिव पॉपुलेशन यहाँ पे जो लोअर एनर्जी लेवल में, जो लोअर वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी लेवल में रोटेशनल एनर्जी लेवल्स का जितना पॉपुलेशन होगा उसके हिसाब से यहाँ पर जो इंटेंसिटी होगा पीक्स का, हाइट जो होगा पीक्स का वो डिसाइड होगा. जनरली थ्री फोर में जे इज इक्वल टू थ्री, जे इज इक्वल टू फोर में पॉपुलेशन बहुत ज्यादा होता है. इसकी वजह से उनके लाइंस जो होते हैं, वहां से जो ओरिजिनेट होते हैं लाइंस, वो लाइंस ज्यादा इंटेंस लाइंस होते हैं. वो लाइंस हमेशा ज्यादा इंटेंस लाइन होते हैं, मीन्स वो लाइन की हाइट हमेशा ज्यादा होती है. जैसे R2 एंड P3, R2 एंड P3 आर द लाइंस विच आर हैविंग हायर एनर्जीज. R1, R2 या फिर P2, P3 जो लाइंस होंगे, इनके एनर्जी, इनका जो हाइट होगा वो ज्यादा होगा, बिकॉज दे आर हाईली पॉपुलेटेड इन द लोअर वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी. लोअर वाइब्रेशनल एनर्जी लेवल में रोटेशनल एनर्जीज उनके ज्यादा पॉपुलेटेड होते हैं, इसलिए ज्यादा पॉपुलेटेड है मीन्स ज्यादा नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स उसमें हैं. सो उनका ट्रांजिशन होने का चांस ज्यादा होता है, और उसकी वजह से उनके पीक्स भी ज्यादा इंटेंस आते हैं. पीक्स का जो हाइट होता है वो ज्यादा बढ़ता है. सो दैट इज वाई वी हैव द हायर एनर्जी, हायर हाइट्स फॉर द इंटरमीडिएट पी ब्रांच एंड आर ब्रांच लाइन्स. क्यू ब्रांच लाइन हमें यहाँ पे नहीं मिलती है. इसकी वजह से क्या होता है कि जो गैप होता है, ये दोनों के बीच का जो गैप है, दिस गैप इज ऑफ 4B0. बाकी सारा जो गैप्स होता है, दिस ऑल गैप्स आर 2B0. बाकी सारी लाइंस में 2B0 का गैप होता है, सिर्फ P0 एंड R0 के बीच में 4B0 का गैप होता है. बिकॉज वी हैव द इक्वेशन न्यू बार इज इक्वल टू न्यू बार जीरो प्लस 2B0, एंड न्यू बार इज इक्वल टू न्यू बार जीरो माइनस टू बी जीरो. ये हमारा पी जीरो का होता है और ये हमारा होता है आर जीरो का. सो आर जीरो एंड पी जीरो के बीच में ये प्लस टू एंड माइनस टू बी जीरो होते हैं. सो इन दोनों को मिलाएंगे तो हमारा टोटल जो डिफरेंस होगा, दैट टोटल डिफरेंस विल बी ऑफ फोर बी जीरो. सो पी ब्रांच और आर ब्रांच लाइन पी जीरो एंड आर जीरो के बीच में फोर बी जीरो का डिफरेंस होगा, बाकी सभी जगह पे हमारा टू बी जीरो का डिफरेंस होगा. ये आपको MCQs में पूछ सकते हैं या फिर आपको ये कंपिटेटिव एग्जाम्स में भी आ सकता है. सो प्रेडिक्ट अगर करना है हमें क्यू ब्रांच लाइन कहां पर आएगी, तो इन दोनों के बीच का जो होगा, दैट विल बी योर लाइन, दैट इज न्यू बार जीरो विल बी गिविंग अस द क्यू ब्रांच लाइन. न्यू बार जीरो का जो वैल्यू होगा, दैट विल बी अवर क्यू ब्रांच लाइन. बाकी हमारा पी ब्रांच लाइन, क्यू ब्रांच लाइन हमें दिखता नहीं है, लेकिन वी कैन प्रेडिक्ट द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ क्यू ब्रांच लाइन्स, दैट विल बी इक्वल टू न्यू बार जीरो, फंडामेंटल वाइब्रेशनल फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द बॉन्ड. सो दिस इज फॉर द वाइब्रेशनल रोटेशनल स्पेक्ट्रम. वी विल सी इट इन आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास अबाउट द अनहार्मोनिसिटी स्पेक्ट्रम और द अनहार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर्स. थैंक यू.